I find it very common in Indonesia that Muslims are marrying non-Muslims and they do it so freely. And while traveling in this few days, I realized that Muslim parents willingly give their daughters to marry a non-Muslim. If a Muslim parents give their daughters in marriage to a non-Muslim, most probably even you will be held responsible. Why do the Muslim parents of Indonesia give their daughters and their sons in marriage to non-Muslims? How are you doing it? Allah clearly states in the Quran, in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 221, that do not marry Mushrika until she believes. A believing woman is far better than a Mushrika, even if she allows you. That means you do not marry a Mushrik girl until she believes. A believing woman, even if she's a slave woman, even if she's a servant, she is far better than a Muslima, even if she allows you. She may be the Queen of England, she may be the most beautiful woman in the world, but if she's a non-Muslim, a Muslim woman who's a slave woman is far superior. Why don't the Muslims of Indonesia know that? The verse continues, do not marry a mushrik, do not marry an unbelieving man until he believes. A believing man, a slave man, a servant who's a poor man is far superior than a non-Muslim, even if he allows you. He may be the most handsome man in the world, he may be the king of the world, but a man who has belief, faith is far superior. I think the Indonesian parents don't read the Quran with understanding. In my country, India, if the children of a Muslim parent marry a non-Muslim, 99% they'll be thrown out of the family. Here, the parent is very happy. My daughter is marrying a Christian, my daughter is marrying a Hindu, my son is marrying a Hindu lady and he wants to become Hindu, and they laugh. What's happened to the Muslims of Indonesia? I want all the universities in Indonesia, in the Islamic studies, to make it a point that do not marry non-Muslim. I'm shocked. When we go to a minority Muslim country, they excommunicate the person. The parents dishonor. Here, make it very clear that if you have an option between marrying a non-Muslim who may be the king of the world, who may be the most handsome man, who may be the most beautiful, who may be Richard Gere, anyone. He may be Bill Gates. But a Muslim man who's a servant, who may be the most ugliest man in the world, he is far superior because he has Iman. If you have Iman, you will go to Jannah. I want to tell the Muslim men, do not marry non-Muslim women. She may be the most beautiful woman in the world, not Indonesia. She may be the most wealthiest woman in the world. She may be a queen. But if you have a Momina, a believing woman who may be the most ugliest woman in the world, who may be a slave woman, she is far superior because she will take you to Jannah. She is your Mohsena. The Quran says your wife is a Mohsena. Mohsena means fortress against the devil. If you marry a non-Muslim, they are a fortress of the devil, not against the devil.